Thank you so much. Thank you so much for starting off with that beautiful song, Prayers of the Children. Welcome to this community listening forum, sponsored by the Eden Prairie Ministerial Association. My name is John Urbanski, and I am currently serving as president of the Immanuel Congregation. As we begin this afternoon, as you are able, please stand, and we will recite the Pledge of Allegiance together.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you again for being here today. The goal of this event this afternoon, first and foremost, is to build relationships in our community between us, our neighbors, and our elected officials. As these relationships develop, I believe there is hope that the divisiveness we see in society will be lessened. For as we know one another better, we are better able to understand one another. Building relationships. This is our goal, and this is why I am here today. Interestingly enough, over the past several weeks, this theme has been evident in many places. Here at Immanuel, we are building relationships, we are having 300 faith-to-faith conversations. People of the congregation having conversations with others, and also the community at large. Also, there was a recent column in the Star Tribune written by Laurie Sturtevant suggesting that there is hope that we can overcome ideological barriers. She discussed the Civil Conversations Project at the Humphrey School of Public Affairs as a collaborative effort to allow us to walk in disagreement while maintaining trust that the citizens need to govern together. Her article also cites the Minnesota Council of Churches Respectful Conversations Project, where people of faith can come together to discuss issues in a respectful way. And just last week, a Lutheran magazine article focused on how Martin Luther looked to this issue. His idea was that we must first look for and listen to the needs of the community, and then act first for the good of the community. All of these sources keep coming back to the same point, relationships. Relationships are the key to our growing together in trust and community, working together for the betterment of society. I am pleased that so many of you are here today to take a step forward in reaching this goal. Thank you again for being here. At this time, I would just like to point out that in the back of the program, on the last page, there's a list of candidates who are here today. You can see those listed. Thank you for your, we'll get a chance to meet them at your tables and also up front here later in the program. So thank you, candidates, for being here today. Also, as we begin today, keep in mind we'd like there not to be any audio or video recording. No video or audio recording, please, for the respect of the participants at the event. And before I introduce our moderator, I would like to begin with a word of prayer. Dear God, thank you for the opportunity to gather here today and for the participation of each person gathered here. We pray that those here today will feel your presence as we look to build relationships. Help us to be open to the words and ideas of others as we grow in relationship with each other and enhance the common bond we share in this community. Amen. At this time, I'll call upon our moderator for the day, Chapin Hall. He must be hiding behind me. There he is. Chapin will be guiding us through this afternoon's events. Chapin, welcome.
Thank you, John. I'd like to extend my own warm welcome to all of you. Thank you for taking time out of your Sunday afternoon to be here for this listening session. For me, One of the reasons I'm here is that as a community, as a common unity, we're knit together in the fabric of our society. And when that fabric is torn, it hurts all of us. And so it's a wonderful thing to get together and to have a listening session and to talk about some of the needs and cares of our community. One thing I'd like to let you know is we did put out invitations to all candidates on both sides of the aisle, and some of the candidates, because they had other matters, could not be here, but we did extend invitations to both Republicans and Democrats. And so some of the candidates who aren't here, we did give invitations to Dave Hahn and Lori McKendry, to Yvonne Seltzer, and to Kirk Stensrud, and I don't think they could be with us. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce Pastor Dan Schneider Bryan from Eden Prairie United Methodist Church.